Welcome to Strings and More Halloween episode.
Episode 20.
Yeah. Episode 2-0.
It's exciting.
On the Halloween. I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to try it. That's really bad.
Oh,
you were like the cat from Sesame Street. Like, one.
One. Two.
Oh, Jamie.
What?
You got some cleavage. In your unicorn suit. Hello, everybody.
Welcome. Hi.
Jazz. To Strings and More, episode 20. Our podcast about knitting. And did you have spinning this week?
No. Oh. I was supposed to. I didn't.
Yarn, bags, projects that we're going to do.
A little bit of.
And Halloween. So we are dressed up. And we have really cool fall decor.
Yes.
See? It's up there. If it is your first time joining us, then thank you for joining us on this really cool special episode. And if you are a returning viewer, then thanks so much for coming back. We hope you enjoy like what we look like, because we don't have a lot of projects for you today.
No.
Yeah. So basically you're just watching us like dressed up like things. Jamie is a unicorn.
I am a unicorn, and there's a story behind it. I'm not just a unicorn to be a unicorn.
Yeah. So, if you'd like to take us seriously, then you can check us out on social media. You can find me as Lambstrings. I'm the owner and dyer behind Lambstrings Yarn. You can find me as Lambstrings on Ravelry. And you can find me as Lambstrings Yarn on Instagram, Twitter, and Periscope. You can also find my beautiful hand-dyed yarns, which, as always, I will show you a little bit later in the episode, at lambstrings.etsy.com to purchase.
You're just adding things to that list.
did I add something to the list?
And periscoping? Or has that been on
That's
there
always
for
been
a while?
On there. Do you even watch our podcast?
No.
David doesn't even watch us.
Nope.
No, Periscope. No, I'm on Periscope. I don't Periscope. I watch other people Periscope.
We should Periscope one night.
I don't know how. I've seen, like, I hate to do it, like, and not know what I'm doing.
Yeah.
Something just fell downstairs.
Yeah, I heard that.
Yeah.
Something just hit.
Yeah, you do, but
like,
then, like,
go.
You're live. Anyway.
Well, so then you just be like, hi.
I know, but what if I say stuff? Do you know how much editing I do with this podcast? Girl.
I'll be there to edit you. I'll be like, beep.
I know. I feel something coming on. Ah, la, 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 la. All right. Jamie, you're on social media as well.
And yeah, I am a little bit. I do dye yarn. Yeah. So you can find me on Ravelry as Jamie M. And on Instagram, as Leslie G Knits. And then you can find my hand-dyed yarn at lesliegknits.etsy.com.
That's right.
And I will be having an update soonish. I don't know when. I'll let you guys know.
Yes.
On Instagram.
Yeah.
Follow the Instagram.
The most important place to follow us, if you haven't been watching, to find out when we're going to update our shops is obviously through Instagram. It is the easiest for us to do, and it gets the word out to everybody. Instagram's like the new Facebook or whatever. Yes. Anyway, it's Saturday, but we're probably going to air this. Usually I get them up on Monday. So happy Halloween, everybody.
Yeah, happy Halloween. Yay.
And let's talk about our costumes. I'm a skeleton. I have their skeletons in my hair and my face and my shirt.
It's pretty cool.
It's pretty easy. Yeah. Jamie is a unicorn.
But
she's not just a unicorn.
No. I am not just a unicorn. So, how do I even say this?
Have you guys seen Deadpool?
Yeah, have you seen Deadpool? Because if you haven't, you will not get this at all.
If you have seen Deadpool, then you know that Jamie is part of a couple's costume.
Yes, my husband, has, like, the same kind of, like, it's pajamas.
It's pajamas. Jamie gets to wear pajamas.
I'm wearing pajamas.
I have eyeliner in my
they've
mouth.
They've got pockets, too, which
you
is
get to
wonderful.
Wear pajamas.
Pajamas. it's a little hot, though, so.
Yeah.
My husband has a Deadpool one,
yeah.
So we are going as Deadpool and his unicorn.
Is that hilarious? I think that's like the best costume. They were going to surprise my fiance and I were going to be at his family's house for a party tonight, and they were going to surprise us, and her daughter just like blurted it out at lunch. She was like, my mommy's the unicorn! Like, because we were talking about it. I think she was just like,
she's
tired
like,
of us
unicorn.
was like, well, I guess we'll just tell you guys, but that's hilarious. Yeah. So we will have pictures. Hopefully I'll have pictures up.
Yes, we'll put pictures up somewhere. Yeah, somewhere. On the Instagram, so I'm sure there'll be pictures.
So, yeah. We, that's it. That's what we are. So, let's talk about, we decided that we didn't do anything this week. So we don't have our week to talk about.
We don't have very much to talk about.
Nothing.
Do you have any FOs?
I don't have any FOs today.
Me either. Let's talk about FOs. Oh, we have none.
Wait a minute!
There just kidding. Are none of those.
There are zero FOs. I know.
I did not do much knitting at all. I read a lot. And what? I watched X-Files.
Jamie's watching X-Files.
I am.
From the beginning. And finally discovering, I guess, I don't know, let's say 20 years too late, that Mulder is hot.
He is such a hottie. It is definitely a perk to watching that show.
I know. He's just got so much emotional baggage, and that needs to... I know. But David Duchovny was a good-looking guy. He's still all right. The Botox is keeping him up pretty good, I feel like.
Botox.
Yeah. But that's about it. But what a great show to watch, like, from the beginning. And the week before Halloween.
Yeah.
I'm watching, you know what, I'm marathoning all the American Horror stories
again. I want to watch those, too. I saw, like, one or two episodes of one of them.
Some of them are good, some of them aren't.
The one where the boy is a ghost and the girl can see him.
Every single American Horror Story show.
Well, okay, fine, that doesn't help.
I know, Seth was like, we're watching it, and Seth's like, is this just all about ghosts? And I'm like, yeah, there's ghosts in all of them. But they're pretty good. I had a nightmare the other night, because I was watching it really, really late. Then I had a nightmare, so I was like, yes, Halloween.
Yay,
I mean, like, obviously I woke up, and it was fine, but... I did. I woke up and I was like, ugh!
Yeah,
I know. You wake up like that and you're like, oh, it's Halloween.
I had a dream about aliens, but it wasn't scary. I woke up and I was like, well, we're watching the X-Files.
It wasn't scary. Was it sexy?
No.
Was it like Mulder alien sexy?
Did it have Mulder in it? No. Oh, I would have told you. If
damn it.
It would have been like Shanna.
This is really a podcast about knitting and stuff. We'll see. I don't know. There's stuff over here.
We promise there's knitting things around
us. If you spell that, you won't be able to see it.
Yeah, I know, it's white. It matches. What?
So that's what we're doing this week. We just marathoned all the scary stuff to prepare us for nothing.
Oh,
Halloween's on Monday.
I'm up to the last season of Friends, finally.
Oh.
I've been watching.
Now you're going to know what happens.
Well, I'm trying to think. I think I saw the last episode.
Yeah, we all know what happens, but
I don't know.
So what? Yay, Jamie. Okay, so no FOs, obviously.
Sorry.
Can we talk about our sweater along? Because that's whips. I'm just going to go right into whips.
Yeah.
Because we have a lot of whips.
We have no FOs, so.
Yeah, and I have a lot of whips.
Good,
I know you have a lot of whips.
I have two. A lot. I have the mustache still. Do you want that to come back?
No more mustache. You already have a costume.
It's an amazing.
Oh, Jamie's costume has a tail also.
Yeah.
So we're going to show you her butt.
Awesome. You can see my butt.
All right, whips. Sweater along.
Uh-huh.
We at Strings and More are currently hosting a sweater along that runs until December 15th. So.
You have 2 months. Well, now a little less than 2 months.
Yeah, a little less than 2 months. Actually, I should put up the FO thread. I haven't done that yet, so hopefully by the time this airs, I will have that. You can go to our Strings and More Ravelry group, which, as you know, if you're a frequent watcher, we never talk about.
We always forget until
we always forget.
We have a knit along. Oh, right, the Ravelry group. We have that thing.
So, go to Strings and More Ravelry group, join our group so that you can participate in all of our alongs and discussions and things like that. Mm-hmm. Yes. So the sweater along. I hope you guys are on board with this because it's that time of year. And like I said last episode.
Oh, the sweaters.
Yeah. Or I'm like in a sweater mode. Like that's all I want to knit. I just want to knit sweaters. You have a sweater too.
I have a sweater.
Did
you knit any more to your sweater?
Not even that much. You know what? I was like, I have 2 months. So I knit a little bit more on the sweater for the sweater along, and then I started to knit another sweater for myself. Because
that's the way you gotta do it.
I have a terrible case of the cast-ons, and that's what's happening.
I like those needles.
These are, I'm going to show you everything. So, as you know, hopefully, currently I am working on the Stonewall cardigan. No, it's just a pullover. Stonewall pullover, by Alicia Plummer. So I did actually, I barely worked on it. I thought I worked on it more than I did, but I barely did. This little croissant right here, this progress keeper, is where I was last week. So,
Oh, and I am using
Jamie's profanity.
you were using my profanity.
I know, I just said it. I have this little fox marker, end of round marker from Pitter Patter Polymer that I'm sporting because it's fall. So yeah, I really knit like 3 inches since last week, which is like nothing. But I'm working on, this is Barocco Vintage in the Wisteria colorway, which is coming out a little orange because of that light, but that's okay. And the needles I'm using are the Chiagu circular interchangeable lace needles. I say that all out of order. They're Chiagus, and I love them. Speedy. So yeah, I haven't even made it through my first skein of yarn yet.
Almost.
Look, with it's got a, like a long dog hair on it. We're not on drugs.
I was just taking a sip of my glasses. I was like, oh, that's fun.
So anyway, yeah, doing that. I think I put in the down bar or in the notes last week that I'm following somebody else's modifications pretty much to the T because I really like the way it looks. So I'll put that up again if you want to see what she did and what I'm doing. In my so-and-so bag. Ophelia. Which I feel like is very Halloween because...
It is very Halloween.
You see a little girl wearing a cat mask.
Cat girl.
For Halloween.
Cat girl.
Oh my god. So yeah. It's a bottom-up sweater and I just didn't make it very far at all because I started something else.
Okay. So I'm going to show you guys how far I got.
Yeah.
I'm doing the Ready for Fall sweater by Isabel Kramer.
Yes.
In Rowan Wool, Pure Wool DK. So, this is how much I have. And I have this little progress keeper from Barbara the Flame and Fiber podcast. She was handing them out at Rhinebeck.
Yes.
So, I'm going to put this.
I should move my progress keeper.
So, I'm going to show you guys. See? Watch where I put it. Oh, snap! I did nothing.
You did nothing. You didn't work on it at all this week?
No.
Okay. If we botch our towel, it's going to be really embarrassing.
No. We've got a month and a half. We're good.
Right? Okay. But you heard that? Yeah, like a month and a half.
So, yeah, I did not work.
That's some foreshadowing right there.
Yep. I'm so sorry.
So, yeah, and this is Jamie's first color work project, her first, like, stranded color work project, so she's a little nervous. Yeah,
the color work will be down here. Whoop, there we go.
It's down, yeah.
Yeah, it's on the end, the bottom. This is the neck.
Yeah.
And it's all the way at the bottom. So I don't have to worry about it down. Until the end.
Yeah. Well, yep.
you're
going to freak out. I feel like Jamie's going to get to that part, and she's going to be like, she's going to have, like, a out-of-body experience with it. I think you'll be fine.
I don't know. We'll see. It's gonna be my first color work. We'll see how it goes.
Yeah.
My sweater will be nice. It'll be like this, and then the color work will be like... Just those sound effects, too, are going to happen.
So here's the deal. Here's what I think Jamie should do. When you get to that part where you think you're going to pull really tight, just take, like, 2 shots. Calm down and just be loose.
Be loose.
Be loose. Take your shots. Be loose. And I think that'll be the cure-all for
this. I think I need to take the hood off. I'm like,
ugh. But now it's not so magical.
Ugh, but it's hot.
It's so good. Like, I'm so glad that we dressed up.
My cheeks are red.
Yeah.
Well, my hair is funky too.
Your hair looks good.
Oh, now.
Yeah. I think your hair looks good.
Thank you.
Yeah. It's a good length.
It's very curly today.
So, our sweater along. If you are interested in participating and you don't feel like going to the Ravelry group right now, we do have our set of rules there, but We should talk about our rules every time, I feel like, because there's plenty of time to still join it.
New viewers, they might be like, oh, a sweater along.
A sweater
along. Look at these people, it's a unicorn and a skeleton. I want to play.
Right? I mean, who doesn't want to play? We're playing. So the rules for our sweater along are that it started on October 15th. We would really, really love, if you entered, if you started one October 15th or later, that's fine. That's ideal. But if you do have a sweater that's it's 20% done already and you want to enter it, enter it. We encourage you to double dip into other threads because I know we're not the only ones doing a sweater along. So you could do that. It is one entry per person for our thread. But again, double dipping is totally cool.
It can't be a tee.
Right.
No tees. It has to have at least 3/4 sleeves.
Yes. Or longer. Mm-hmm. Full length to 3/4 length sleeves qualifies as a sweater.
Could be a pullover, a cardigan, a shrug?
A little chunky shrug with long sleeves, whatever. Like something that goes over you.
Sweater. When you could do something this. You would call a sweater,
guys. I don't know. It's a sweater. Yeah. It's a sweater. If it looks like a sweater and feels like a sweater, it could be an hour sweater along, and that'd be great.
And it could be as easy or difficult as you like.
Cables?
My voice sounds weird. Why?
Sockway? I don't know. You got like chipmunky.
There we go.
Oh, ooh. Jamie's always got some digestive stuff going on. It's like that.
It's the drink.
It's the... It's the sauce.
The sauce.
It's the sauce. Adult sweaters, please. No baby sweaters. That's just not, not enough. We require more
substance.
But yeah, we do have a chatter thread open in our Ravelry group, and we would love for you to come down.
Those two colors look really good together.
Jamie's getting distracted. I swear she's not drinking.
It's hot chocolate, people.
Yeah, so come down to our chatter thread. We are reading everything. There are quite a few Madewells and Featherweight cardigans that people said they were going to do, and I'm really excited because those always look really, really great, especially when you're using hand-dyed yarn, which most of you are. A lot of people are using hand-dyed yarn.
I'm going to do a Featherweight cardigan, too, not in hand-dyed yarn. I'm sorry.
I said I was going to do a Featherweight in something, but I haven't decided yet. I did decide on a lot of other things, so there's our whole segment about, like, what we're gonna do. Like, our whole, like, BS segment about what we're gonna do. And then, like...
Someone said they liked that, though, and we were glad. We bought this yarn to make this, and
I know. Never do things. She was like, I feel like I'm not the only one. And I was like, good, we are so not the only one. I just, whatever.
We do it all the time.
We do it all the time. Yeah. But, whatever, so what if we don't do it? At least it gives you guys ideas. And they're good ones.
Yeah, good idea. It's good to bring up different patterns, and then people will go and they will look at them and they'll be like, oh, I like that. Maybe they'll make
it. Adding that to my favorites. Good. Do it. I have another whip. Because I said I have lots of whips. Yes. And what that really means is that I have two.
Oh, you only have two?
I only have two.
Two.
I know. I'm so, we're so dramatic. I'm like, so many whips. Oh, my God. And there's...
Well, our last episode was, what, an hour and 40 minutes? This one will be 40 minutes.
I know. This one won't be that long. But that's okay. Because, you know, so what? You could watch on your lunch break. It's going to be longer than 40 minutes. I did start, like I said I was going to start, the Rachel pullover by Josie Paquin, I believe. So, this is, and I'm, like, humiliated to say it, my first time doing a sweater in this kind of construction. So, basically, you cast on for the back first, you work up to the armpit, and then you cast on for the two fronts. You pick up the shoulders and you cast on for the two fronts. You do it that way, and then they meet in the middle. They meet at the arm. Well, they meet completely at the armpit.
What is it called? I have to look at this.
It's called Rachel. I'm going to say that again because I feel like that was like not structured the way I said it. You cast on for the back, and you work until the armpit. Then put that on waist yarn. You pick up the shoulders, and you work the two fronts separately. They connect into your collar, and you work straight until the armpit, and where you start to you connect them both, and then you work in the round to the bottom. Then you pick up the sleeves and you work this way.
Where do you have this thing in your queue?
I do. No, I don't know. I've been so, like, lax in neglecting my Ravelry page.
You have. You're so bad.
I know. Yeah. So, yeah. So, it's just, it's from the top down. And I've always either done raglan sleeves when I did a top-down sweater, or I've done the contiguous set-in sleeve method by Susie Myers. So I have never, like, picked up the shoulders and done the fronts and stuff like that. That always turns me off because you're weaving so many ends. I like the one piece, no seams, blah, blah, blah. But I really like this pullover, and it's supposed to be a little, like, oversized. It's supposed to be, like, a little loose, like 2 inches of positive ease or something like that. I don't know if I'm going to have that. So, I don't know. I might just block the you-know-what out of it and see if I can get it. But, yeah, this is the back. Oh, it's nothing. And then I picked up by the shoulders there, and now I'm working the left front. And I'm using, the Chiagu circular interchangeable lace knitting needles in size 5 instead of 6, which I think is going to give me some trouble later, but I don't know. We'll see. And I'm using Lambstrings yarn in the Flint colorway. This is Lambstrings Tralala Sock, 75% superwash merino and 25% nylon. New colorway, Flint. Very little speckle gray with some light chestnut brown. I really like the way this is working up. It's like semi-solid, which I feel like I haven't used that in a long time. I need like a semi-solid sort of, I'm ready for like a not crazy speckled cardigan, you know, simple. So yeah, so I'm excited about that. It's working up quickly right now because there's not a lot to do. So I'll let you know when it starts getting like headache worthy because it's a sock yarn pullover. But I am using 2 skeins and I am alternating them because, you know, I do that.
You do that.
I alternate the skeins. Yeah. That's my other sweater that's not part of the sweater along, but I'm excited about it. Those are all of my whips at the moment. Do you have any other whips?
You do. I do. Yeah. Where are you?
Doo-doo, where are you?
Doo-doo, where are you? Is your mighty sounds up there?
Yeah. This is the one that she got at Rhinebeck.
Yes.
There's another one.
There is another one over there.
She bought another one.
So I've had in my head a while an idea for a beaded sock weight yarn hat, and I haven't gotten much done. So it's I'm working with Legacy Fiber Arts.
Yeah,
it knits up real nice. It.
Yeah.
So hold on. That did nothing.
The color is weird on the iPad.
Because I'm wearing the white.
Yeah, it's everything is trying to focus on the colors and white balance it.
Yeah, I feel like it's
it's getting a little washed out.
What if I do?
That didn't work at all.
That didn't work out. Nope. All right, so it's a little washed out.
Yeah. Here, put it up to the thing. There you go.
That's a little better.
Yeah, that works.
This is sweater weather.
Sorry, guys.
Yeah, it's still a little,
a little
washed out. It's not terrible.
It's a little bit more saturated than what you're seeing.
Yeah.
But that looks really nice.
It's
that does work up
really
nice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's going to be a hat. It's got a brim that you can fold over.
It's the sock head hat, right?
No.
No?
No, sock head.
I thought you
were
the sock head hat.
No,
oh, you're just doing this.
Yeah.
Jamie, she's so creative.
I was thinking about sewing it in.
Uh-huh.
Not sewing it in, you know, like where you do the brim and then you knit it together.
Oh, so yeah. You do like a provisional cast on and then you flip it and knit it right in.
I didn't do that.
No, she should. This is for a friend, so she should be able to flip it or not flip it over if she wants to. She should be able to have that option. When you're doing it for other people, it's hard, you know?
Hi, what did I do?
I think you twisted a stitch and put it on the needle. Oh.
No, my
There you go.
That's what I did. Okay. Well.
I forgot to talk about my stitch marker, so I have to do that when you're done.
So it has beads.
But you are putting beads in there.
Yeah, I am. Can you see them? They're there.
Yeah, she put little orange seed beads.
Little orange seed beads.
That's really cool.
So I've got, like, nothing done except for the brim.
It's sock yarn. I mean, a lot of the stuff we're doing is out of sock yarn, so it's going to be a while.
I got a lot left.
So, yeah, well.
And these are.
Yeah. The little seed beads. What size are those?
6.
A 6 millimeter?
6 e-bead.
0.6 millimeter.
Yep.
But yeah, this was the yarn that Sue gifted us at Rhinebeck. So, I have an idea for mine too, and it's also a hat, so we'll talk about that too.
This is what I've been knitting on as I was watching X-Files.
It's hard to knit and love David, you know, at the same time.
That's why not much is done.
I know.
Too busy staring at the screen.
He's getting distracted.
Damn it. And my little stitch marker for Miss Babs.
Yeah.
Can you see? It's a pumpkin. Very Halloween-y. There he is. Aww.
Is that your only, is that your last whip?
Yeah.
Can we talk about the bag that you got that matches the obsession that you have this week?
Yes.
And Halloween?
I really should have had this in this bag.
Yeah, what are you doing?
So I got a new You So-and-So bag. Because she posted this on Instagram, and I looked at it, and I was like, I need that.
So I'm seeing the inside for the first time right now, and it's amazing. It. It's totally amazing.
Aliens.
Aliens.
I had to get it.
Aliens.
And I, is that like, adorable? Even in the picture, I looked, I was like, does that glow in the dark?
Does it?
And I'm like, hello, no, it's, the picture was in daytime, like, it's not glowing, it's just, the green is so, like,
bright and awesome, bright. And matches your hair, totally, like, and she's watching the X-Files.
And I'm watching the X-Files, and check out the inside.
And look at the inside.
Real UFOs.
Hello? That's really, really cute.
It's the best bag ever.
Sarah, you are just so, you're I can't.
Alien man.
Oh, yeah, on the little...
Yeah, really the little, cute. Her little tag.
Yeah, her little tabs. She just has, like, the coolest combos. Like, they always just look so great together.
I thought it was the coolest thing. I said, I need that. I told her, I think I commented, I need that bag, and then, like, a few days later,
like,
I
bought right it. Now. Right now. So cool. But the inside, like, that, what an awesome color. I love that. That's so you, too.
I love green.
Yeah.
Green.
Yeah, the inside of her, the inside of her stuff is just amazing. So everything is covered in dog hair. Everything this week. Everything has been, like, around the couch, like, on the floor around the couch. Yeah, in mine, she's got the cats on the outside and then the kitties on the inside. Just, like, amazing combinations.
Well, yeah, like,
she's got the gift. The gift. I just love and the birds on the inside. How cute is that?
And the colors always match so well.
Yeah.
So, yeah, that was my acquisition.
Love it. The inside. Like, I can't get over the inside.
Yeah, I know. The inside's awesome.
I really can't get over it. That is just that's just the coolest thing ever. You open the bag and it's, like, bright.
It is. It glows. It's
like, whoa. I have to backtrack because I have to put a progress keeper.
And then it came with a button.
She always sends those really adorable buttons. I have two of them, or three of them. I have a few of them. I have to figure, I have to rack them up and do something really interesting with them.
Anna liked it, so I told her next time I make her a hat, I'd put it on the hat for
Anna
her.
Wants all of it. Every time she sees something, she's like, hey, I'd read that. I'm just going to backtrack into my Rachel sweater again, because hello, derp, it's Halloween. So I have to put my kitty cat Halloween treat basket progress keeper on my thingy, my sweater. My thingy. This thingy. So let me just put that on there real quick. Oh my god. This is the... I love it. Look at her. Oh, that's the back. Look at her. Meow, meow. Meow. Meow, meow.
Our kitty hasn't come back.
Jamie, I'm hopefully, I don't know if you guys are watching for the first time, they have a, her and her husband... have a koi pond in the backyard. And I guess last week, or something.
Sometime last week, I think. Did we talk about it last podcast?
I don't know. I have to sneeze. I think we did.
We had a kitty visitor. And I put it on my Instagram. I think I have a video of us being like, look at the kitty!
The kitty decided it was going to pop into the backyard and, like, hunt the koi.
Yeah.
Like,
but she was also saying hi to us, and it was,
she was
very cute.
Yeah.
So, we can't have kitties, so it was nice.
Yeah, Jamie's allergic. Jamie's allergic to lots of stuff.
Oh, we're getting our first tattoo soon.
You are?
Yeah.
Jamie.
First tattoos. We're 30. We're getting our first tattoos.
I don't have any. I'm like dying for one, but I really.
I have every single tattoo I want planned out, where I want it, what I want it. It's just I haven't gone to do it yet. It costs money.
It costs money, and it hurts. And that's my big thing.
I'm not worried about it hurting. I'm worried about being allergic to the freaking ink.
Yeah. So Jamie's like, I'll try it. If I'm allergic, we'll just cut it out.
Well,
like, she's out of control. I'm like,
it's a small one. It's going to be on my leg. So if anything happens, if I am allergic to the stupid ink, because I'm allergic to metals, because I'm allergic to everything, and, like, to the point where, like, certain jeans, the button on the jeans, I get a rash from that. It's wonderful. I can't wear watches.
And this is all. Jamie has all these.
I can't wear
issues.
Earrings.
No, we were
I used to have
those.
Earrings, yeah, and I can't wear them anymore.
So she's got all these problems, right? And she's like, I'll try a tattoo anyway. I have none of these problems, and I'm like, oh my god, it's gonna hurt. Like,
I'm not worried about it hurting.
What a wuss! I'm a wuss. I don't know. I keep telling Seth someday, it's gonna happen. But I don't know what I'm gonna do. I'm afraid, like. You ever see those videos of those girls that, like, have, like, they're like, ah! They, like, are crying the whole time. I'm like, oh my god, if that's me, I'm not gonna be able to finish
it. So you start with something little in a place that doesn't hurt that bad.
Like, where? A heart on my butt, because there might be fat there.
Well, like, we're getting, but then, I'll tell you guys what we're getting. We're gonna get our children's birth dates in Roman numerals.
Yeah. Which, and the way they have it set
on
up
our
is,
legs.
This way, instead of Roman numerals this way.
Yeah.
It's gonna be top to bottom. And I, like, Ron showed us the design. It's really, like, classy.
So, gonna do it on the leg. I figured, you know what, I wear jeans all the time anyway. If I have an allergic reaction to it, most allergic reactions to ink, I think we're saying, it's just, it'll, like, you get it, like, red. It'll be red for like a week or two and it'll go away.
We'll just take a scalpel to it.
Worst case, they have to cut it out of your skin.
Yeah. No biggie. I'll just see what happens. Jamie.
So,
you're out of control.
Oh, what else am I going to do? How else am I going to be?
What's that from Friends?
My mom was like, well, just go to a tattoo place and have them tattoo in a line. And I was like, no, just get a tattoo.
A dot. Phoebe's dot.
It's
the earth from space from a great, great distance or whatever. I feel like that's, like, when cats can lick it on, like, I want my tattoo to be licked on by kittens, that's when I'll get a tattoo. I'm just a wuss. I'm a total wuss. And I'm psyching myself out, too. Things usually aren't as bad as I think they are, but I really want a knitting tattoo, a yarn tattoo.
And meanwhile, Seth has, like, a tattoo.
Seth has his whole, his shoulder and up here is covered, and then his whole side, like, the whole thing is covered up to his chest. Like, he's just covered. He's getting a new one. And they look good. They look good. But ow. I can't, you know what it is? I have to sleep when he had gotten everything done, and I had to sleep next to him, watching the pain. And
well, because he got half of his freaking body done. You're not going to get half of your body done.
When kittens can do it.
When kittens can.
I want a giant snake that starts, like, on my leg and comes up, then twisty and comes up and, like, into my chest. It's so tacky. And every time I see something like that, I'm like, I want that. But I'm never going to do it.
I want half sleeves. I want my shoulders down to my elbow.
Yeah. This is a podcast.
If I don't have an allergic reaction, if I do, then Ron will get all the tattoos, and that's okay.
You'll be able to admire them.
Mm-hmm.
Which I have no problem with that. I want one, but, like, I just like to admire them on Seth. Like, show me your chest. Okay, good. it's like such rare form today.
Yeah, we're
such like, weird. It's a weird day.
We started the day. What are we going to talk about? We don't have much. We're going to talk about our white nonsense. All right, let's talk about yarn.
We're going to, I hope, don't thumbs down this episode, because that really hurts my feelings.
Really?
Yeah, it does.
Yeah, I don't care.
I'm always like, oh, somebody doesn't like it. Anyway, projects that we're going to do next with the yarn that we have. Sue from, I am going to use it. Sue from Legacenets did gift both of us a skein of her sweater weather yarn at Rhinebeck. So I decided what I was going to do with it. I decided I was going to do the Bayard hat by Bristol Ivy. That's a Brooklyn Tweed published pattern. So it uses two colors, and it's a stripey hat. And then it looks like there's a little bit of brioche in the back, or a little bit of color work in the back. It's a really interesting, like, simple but interesting pattern. So I'm going to use the sweater weather for the color A, I guess, the lighter colorway. And hello, I totally have some red maple left over from my carbon fingerless mitts in just the right amount. So I'm going to put them together. I think it'll look interesting, mm-hmm. You know?
I think they'll look good.
Yeah, they both have, like, orange undertones. Mine has a little bit of, like, a purple plummy undertone, and she has some purple in her sweater weather. So we'll see how that works. I figure,
and both have, yeah, the orangey and gold.
Yeah. It's a great unity of hand-dyed yarn and podcasters. So, that'll be what that hat's about. Yeah. I think it's going to be interesting. I'm so, like, it's difficult for me to put colors together, like hand-dyed yarns together. Sometimes I just really worry that they're not going to work out. And people do it. The people put colors together, they look so beautiful. So, mm-hmm. I'm going to try it. That's one of my next projects. What are you going to work on next? Do you have anything next? I have, like, a ton.
No, you know, I didn't even think, I'm going to do the featherweight cardigan, but I already talked about that in Show the Yarn.
Yeah.
So I don't want to do that again. Let's talk about this.
Yeah.
So, you know, Wollenfine and, I'm going to say it wrong, Wolfenschaef. There we go.
Yeah.
Hosted a unicorn along, 2 weeks ago?
2 weeks ago, yeah.
Something?
Yeah.
And my mother won a stitch yarn. And she had it.
And how funny is that? We were like, oh my god, yeah. She won! Like, she did hobby horse.
Yeah, she did a hobby horse unicorn. And she got the skinny yarn. She's like, you know, I really don't know what I'm going to do with it. And then my daughter was like, I love that! She's like, you want it?
The magic words. Yeah, Anna was, of course, because it's pink.
So this is the yarn.
Yeah.
It's, oops, hello.
Hello.
The Fawn and the Fox.
The Fawn and the Fox, which.
And what was the, unicorn, I had to ask. What is
it? The color's called unicorn.
It's unicorn.
But it's sparkly. It's got like that pink and bright green in it. So of course, Jamie's daughter fell in love with it.
Yeah,
Grandma was like, oh, it's yours.
Yeah, so it's
going to
be
Jamie's going to make something with it.
For my daughter.
Yeah.
She told me she wants a Pegasus, and I just looked at her like, really? You want me to knit a Pegasus out of it?
You will do it, though, because your daughter wants it.
Yeah.
Do,
it's just sparkly.
You know, it would be really cute. Like a unicorn hat. Yeah. I think she'd like anything that you make. Her Jamie's daughter is very into the knit objects. She loves all of it.
She will be a knitter one day. Like, I get yarn in the mail, and she's right there next to me.
She does this.
And as soon as I unpack it, she needs a skein to go like this.
Yeah.
And then she tries
it out of my bag. She takes stuff out of my bag, and she's like, yeah, and she gets all squeaky and cute, and Jamie's like, just watch where that goes. To me. She's like, just keep an eye on that, because she'll hide it. I'm like, okay.
She asks me, can this one be my, she has skeins of yarn.
She does.
She's got 2 or 3 skeins of yarn that are hers.
Yeah.
She wanted them, and I said, if you want them.
She loves it. She's going to be a knitter.
Yeah. So she's 4 and a half now. I think still a bit young to teach her.
Yeah. It's
maybe when she's 6 or 7.
The
coordination.
The hand-eye coordination needs to be tweaked a little bit. You know what it is? You start them too young and they can't do it because
it's funny, then you see their coordination and they get frustrated. These little kids doing it.
I guess it depends.
I'm like, they're so young. I don't know.
You could try it. You know, you don't want to get them frustrated and turn them off completely.
Like, I want to teach Caleb, too, and he's 7, and I still can't see him, like,
Caleb could probably do it, though, because he plays video games. He's got great hand-eye coordination, so I wonder if he could... I wonder if crocheting would be easier to teach them to see if they like it, and then work them onto, I feel like...
Up to knitting?
Up to knitting. And I don't mean that in a crocheting so much easier type of way. I mean that in a...
You're
using one.
Yeah.
You know, you're getting the feel of it. You're getting the experience of doing it. And
I do have something I could talk about.
Talking about anything.
Sorry, keep going.
Go, everybody.
Shut up.
This is soft.
It is very soft, isn't it?
Pet. Anyway, what are you working on?
I'm not working on anything. Where's my...
What?
All right, I'll just talk about it because I don't know where my scrap yarns are. So we have a thread open, and it's about what to do with scrap yarn.
The thread is called The Issue of Effing Scrap Yarn. Mm-hmm. And we've had quite a few people comment on what to do with it.
Great. I really liked the Cozy Memories blanket, the Hexy Puff one.
Yeah,
the Hexy Puff, all these sock yarn blankets.
I like them.
But I'm unsure. I want to do a granny square one with fingering weight yarn.
Sue Stokes from Legacy Knits is doing something like that. They're a little hexagon. They're a little sock weight. I'll have to look it up
and
put it up. They're crocheted. They're little hexagon crocheted pieces. She said, I was watching her Periscope, and she was saying that each one takes about 10 minutes, 10 to 20 minutes. So if you could do two in a day.
Squares.
Yeah, you could do a little square. That's what I was thinking, you know.
Yeah. But then the only thing I'm worried about is sewing them all together. But I know, like,
when you crochet, you can crochet them together instead of, like, you can crochet them as you go.
I just have to look that up because I've never done that before.
It's just, you'd have to do, like, every one that you do, you have to sew into itself. Like, you'd have to, you can't make, like, a whole ton from one color and then put it off to the side. Yeah. That's a pain. But
I'll probably just deal with, or you could do that and then crochet, like, down the line. Crochet,
With Jody from the Grocery Girls is hosting a crochet along, and it's like any crochet project that you want to do. But I don't have all the information. I don't know when it ends. I think she's.
I don't think I have enough scraps to do a whole blanket. I'm looking around. There are no scraps.
Well, if you have enough to do a lap blanket, you can.
But I thought it would be nice, like, you know. Keep going. I did think it would be nice to do a little.
Yeah, something like that.
I was thinking about that too. This project, then that color is from this.
You know, right, and have it like a scrapbook.
And I'll probably have a square of this
like
crazy
color. Like a yarn scrapbook.
Yeah.
Yeah, I would, you know, that's a great idea. I worry about my cat. I've said it a million times. I don't want to, like, talk the ear off about it. I worry that the cat's going to gush it, and then I'm going to murder the cat.
Murder the kitty.
Yeah, aww. Nobody touches my stuff. I also have an idea for a next project.
Go ahead.
Another one. Last week, we were showing you all of our yarn from Rhinebeck, and I pulled out the Into the World BFL skein that I had, 400 yards, and I was saying that I really wanted to do a pair of leg warmers with them. So, very fabulous, who's amazing, Dur, Lavanya Patricella, I think her last name is, I hope I'm not butchering that. She's, like, always hanging out with Stephen West, you know, they're, like, groups, hanging out together. She designed a pair of leg warmers that have a brioche top. They're, like, knee highs. They're not leg warmers, they're knee-high socks. So last week I was like, oh, I'm totally gonna wait. She just released it on Thursday. I forget what she called it. I will have that information for you and a photo. But I really, really wanted to do those. So I was waiting for it to come out. And I picked out my yarn and everything. The pattern came out and I did a little research on it. And it turns out that they are toe-up socks. And because they're toe-up socks, they require a lot of yarn. Which I don't plan on doing the foot part of the sock. So I was debating on whether do I want to buy the pattern and then kind of just like started at mid-calf and then go up, and I don't. I think what I'm going to do is just do a brioche top. I'm not going to do it as long, and then I'm just going to knit straight until I run out of yarn. I'll split everything into two so that I can do two socks, but I like the brioche top, so I'm going to use this Into the World and this, it's not called it, but it reminds me of a fox in the snow. I can't pronounce that. What's this yarn called?
Reinerdine.
This color is called Reinerdine. It's 400 yards. I have a little bit left of my Tralala sock in the toasted colorway. So I'm going to pair them together. I'll do a brioche top, and then I'll just knit until like mid-calf and stop. I really just want them, they're boot socks. They're boot leg warmers. They're not really leg warmers. I have a lot of boots that are like almost up to my knee, so I just want something that sticks out of that. So that's what this is going to be. It'll be a work in progress, so I'll keep you guys posted on how it's going. I'm just going to figure it out as I go, I think. I have to split this into two, and I have to split this into two, so that I know, like, I'm just going to stop when I run out of yarn, and however long they are is what they are. So that's my plan for that, and, you know, to have them done so that I can wear them for fall, because that's what this is. But I think they look okay together.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's the plan for that. Fingers crossed it works out. What else you got?
I have yarn-wise.
Oh, yeah.
You want to see why I asked what color you wanted?
Yes! Before this podcast started. Yeah, go ahead. Talk about it.
Go ahead. You do it. You say that little
Jamie's
bit.
Like, pick a color. I'm like, for what? She's like, not going to tell you. I'm like, okay. So she gave me some options, and I picked pink. So what's pink?
So, online, on Facebook, actually, there's, you know how the ads pop up now, you see the ads.
Mm-hmm.
Did my mom share it, or did she tell me about it? Something she wanted for Christmas. I was like, oh, okay, you know, I thought it was cool, so like, all right, I'll get one for you, and I'll get one for Grandma. So they know about it, they know I got it. They see it on here.
I don't know anything.
except it was buy one, get one free.
Mm.
And I was like, oh. And they were on sale.
And I was like,
so
oh.
I bought two, so I got two for free. So we each got one.
Jamie's going to give it to me.
I'm going to give it to you.
Do you know, I was just thinking the other day, if I was looking at these at work, because we sell these at work, they are, they're little electronic counters. And you put them on your finger and you click it, and it tells you how many rows or stitches or whatever you're keeping track of. I was looking at them the other day, and I was like, do I want one of these? I feel like this would be so convenient. You read my mind.
So yeah, you click this, and it counts the rows.
Yeah. And then that little one restarts it. So the big one, right? I did every row. I do this. So when you have a project that says increase every fourth row 8 times, right? You can just, you put it on your finger, and as you work, you click it.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't have to put, like, markers, or you don't have to do anything.
And it just turns off by itself.
Thanks, Jamie!
You're welcome.
That's really cool. You know, I feel like these should just be, like, a fashion item.
Yeah, right?
Like, girl. Oh, I'm glad I picked pink!
Yeah, I was like, Rod, do you think a green one will come? And green one didn't come. I'm just
Jamie and her green. I'm like, she's so ridiculous. Her and her green.
Her and her green.
Yeah. Oh, I want fashion items.
Fashion.
Turn to the left. Ooh.
Thanks, Jamie.
The orange one's really cute, too. Who is this made by? The ones that we sell at work are Susan Bates.
Made in China.
They work. That's all that matters. They
yeah,
work.
SXH? Whatever
yeah.
The heck that is. I think that's probably just a
thing.
I got it at, oh shoot, what is it? Something crafty. I don't remember.
We'll put it up.
Yeah, we'll put it up. It is a craft store. They had cool looking scissors too.
It's just like, it was cool. It was craft.
It is craft.
I think that's all I, yeah. You know, I have other projects that I'm going to start. Not BS, right? Fingers crossed, I'm going to start all these projects. I was looking at and becoming very interested in Hohe Locatelli's worsted boxy.
Oh, that I have big, that in my giant, favorite. Hmm. Yeah.
I have some primrose that I got at Rhinebeck that I'm thinking about striping with something else in there.
For the boxy.
For the boxy, yeah. This is a lot of talk. This episode's a lot of talk, you guys.
Yeah,
so we apologize.
Sorry.
We don't have a lot to show you. This week just, I don't know. This week went by so fast, I feel
it
like.
Did.
Before I knew it, I was like, oh my, what am I going to talk about? I would like to talk about something that hopefully will be up. I don't know when this is going to be up. So in relation to how it's going. But I'm almost at 1,000 followers on Instagram. So
yay!
I think I'm at like 950 something or something like that. So I would love more than anything to do a 1,000 follower giveaway. So I am going to be giving away one skein of Lambstrings yarn, the Utopia DK in the Venery colorway, which is the colorway I had made my cardigan out of last week. So I might put a picture of that up if I have it so you can see how it works up. It is 231 yards of DK weight. Superwash wool, and I would love to give that away. So make sure you go down. There will be some sort of repost thing to enter, and I will be pulling winners for that when I hit 1,000 followers on Instagram. So go follow me. The rules will be there. I haven't done it yet, but the rules will be there by the time this airs. So yeah, that's my giveaway, and then I'll announce the giveaway, or I'll put the giveaway winner on Instagram, and then probably announce them on the next podcast or whenever I hit 1,000 followers.
This color.
This is a great, I don't know if you guys saw it last week. It's an amazing, like, Christmas type of color. And there's enough in here to do a hat or some gloves. There's enough in here to do a lot. So, yeah. Come on down there. Follow me on Instagram. Girlfriend.
Girlfriend.
Girlfriend. Boyfriend.
Sorry.
We're going to end. I think we're done, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. It was a really short podcast. We took longer getting ready than we did podcasting. There's really not that much to talk about. Not
do much.
Yeah. We're going to a Halloween party tonight. We're going to take pictures of Jamie and her husband.
I'm so excited.
I'm going to look like this. I'm debating on whether I even want to take this off. I feel like if I eat, I'm going to be sorry I didn't take this off.
Smudge, yeah.
Yeah. It's eyeliner. I put eyeliner, like, in my mouth.
It's okay.
The things girls do for beauty. You know? Yeah. Oh, Jamie, show them your butt.
You see my butt?
Yeah. Everyone wants to see Jamie's butt? We know that you do.
Can you see it?
Higher.
It's Jamie's higher. Butt. I'm short. Do you know how to do it?
Yeah, that's it. We're gonna go back downstairs. We hear the kids getting restless anyway. I feel like they're walking up the stairs.
Yeah.
So,
they look crazy today.
Yeah. Thank you for, stopping by and spending some time with us. And we wish you the happiest Halloween. Please be safe. Please be something. Dress up. Make sure you dress up.
Have fun.
Have fun. And check all your kids' candy because there's crazies out there. Just saying. You know. And make sure you pick through all their stuff and take all the good things while they're sleeping. My mom used to do that. Bye, guys. Be safe. Happy Halloween.
Happy Halloween.
We'll see you next week.
Bye.
Bye.